Hello, this is Georgina Rose, part-time esoteric content creator and part-time occultist. I'm thinking of a new intro. Comment below if you have any ideas. I've wanted to change it because the old one a lot of people didn't understand. So I'm trying to think of a new one, but I haven't thought of a super cute one yet. But regardless, I'm Georgina Rose. This is a YouTube channel all about the occult, mysticism, magic, esoterica, and more. And welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to be giving a reading guide about ceremonial magic, where I'll essentially be telling you what the most essential ceremonial magic books of all time are, or of all time based on my perspective. So for some background on me, I'm a Thelemite, I'm a ceremonial magician, and this video is going to be about sort of the most influential ceremonial magic text that a young, new ceremonial magician should read. Though, this is not a beginner's guide. I did a general beginner's occultism guide a while back, and I did a Thelema-specific guide a while back, but this is ceremonial magic broadly, regardless of where you fall on the Western ceremonial magic spectrum, whether you're into PGM, planetary magic, Golden Dawn, or Thelema like me, this will be helpful for you because it sort of outlines what you should be reading. So at the beginning, I'm going to be giving one book that's sort of the beginner book of this list, or what I would read first before reading the rest of these. But beyond that, these are kind of more tricky books, more advanced books. Almost all of them are quite old. So obviously you're going to want to read commentaries, look up Discord threads or subreddits discussing these books, speak to the other occultists you know, and do some research to make sure you're understanding what's happening, and to read through them slowly. It's not a rush to the finish. It's not a rush to the bottom of this list. Take them as you need to and read them with the depth that you can, because some of these books are really hard. Some of them will take a long time to read. It took me a long time to read through this whole list. So take your time and don't feel like you need to know all of them tomorrow, or that you need to perfectly comprehend every single concept and idea within them in your first reading. Many people are occultists for decades and do not fully comprehend every single idea ever. Like, I'm still learning, you're still learning, we're all still learning, so make sure you take it at your own pace and don't sort of bash yourself if you struggle with some of these books when you first read them. Give yourself some breathing room and some space to grow. So now let's get into the books. So the first book I'm going to recommend you read is Llewellyn's Complete Book of Ceremonial Magic. This came out about a year or two ago. It was my favorite release the year it came out, and it's a breakdown of a lot of paradigms that exist within ceremonial magic. It's by different authors, so each author of each section is a specialist in the field they're talking about, and it gives you the basics to understand each paradigm. There's a chapter on things like polytheistic ceremonial magic, there's a chapter on the Golden Dawn, there's a chapter on Thelema. So basically there's a chapter on every major system, so you can read this and know, oh, this is what I'm interested in. Obviously, by reading one book, you're not gonna know your path. You're gonna not know exactly what ceremonial magic path is right for you until you start applying the ideas from this book and seeing how the rituals actually work for you. But this can give you a sense of what you're interested in, so you can know which of these books would be the right one for you to read. Which one should you jump into first, and which one would make you feel the most fulfilled as a practitioner. So definitely read that first. I really like that book. I feel like it's kind of similar to my videos in that it breaks down a lot of concepts quickly. As well, I have little videos on a lot of the topics that'll be covered by these 10 books. So the first older text or source book I'm gonna recommend you read is The Golden Dawn by Israel Regardi. So the Golden Dawn was a magical order that existed through the 1800s. There are Golden Dawn groups today, but they are a broken lineage. They're not the exact same group. That doesn't mean those groups are invalid or bad. They're just not precisely what Regardi was a part of. But basically, Regardi wrote this book compiling the entire practices of the order from the lowest degree to the highest, so that people could read through it and sort of recreate these rituals and go through the initiations themselves. This has been the basis for a bunch of Golden Dawn lodges. A lot of these rituals you can do on your own. Personally, I love the lesser banishing ritual, the pentagram. I recommend it to all beginners that you can learn from this book. And it has really good breakdowns of every ritual and everything that the Golden Dawn teaches. So if you read this first, you can get a good contextualization of what a lot of modern ceremonial magic practices are. As well, the Golden Dawn syncretized a lot of older ideas into one solid ritual paradigm. So you can actually use it as a springboard to learn the Golden Dawn stuff, then jump into a lot of these older ideas, because the Golden Dawn really brought them all together into one system, which I think is a really good way to learn, because once you understand some Golden Dawn ideas, you can easily understand things like astrology, Hermeticism, Thelema. Like it gives you tools to understand a lot of systems. And I think this book in particular really gives you those keys to jump into a bunch of frameworks once you're done through it, or maybe you'll just find a love for the Golden Dawn. So the next book I'm gonna recommend is another massive long source book. That would be Liber ABA. Liber ABA can be a little expensive, but it has all the essential Thelemic text. If you're not familiar with Thelema, Thelema was a system that was sort of started by Aleister Crowley that combines all these ideas together. It combines the Golden Dawn, combines some pagan ideas, and it has a distinct philosophy about will through it. I have a video explaining Thelema, but Thelema is a very popular modern system, as well as there's a lot of original ideas coming out of Thelema, such as rituals like the Star Ruby. There's some certain partnered magic that comes out of the Thelema that is unique to Thelema. And the way to learn Thelema would be ABA. ABA has the Book of the Law, which is essentially the holy text of Thelema that Aleister Crowley channeled. It has Magic and Theory and Practice, which is all the big rituals, all the big instructional ideas. It explains the tools Thelemites use. It explains like what the rituals are. It explains things like evocation and barbarous names. So it gives you those foundations to get through all of it. It literally has four books inside of it. It has the Stele of Revealing. It has a bunch of essential Thelemic text. So you can actually get a lot of Thelema really quickly through this book because it has so much within it. It's a master book. It takes a long time to read. And a lot of people do like reading groups to get through it together. It's almost like a little Thelemic tradition to do that. So it's a really good way to understand Thelema, and is the one book, if you can only read one book on Thelema ever, it's the one to read. Certain sections of it are kind of overwhelming, so reading books by like Lon Milo Duquette while working through Liber ABA can be really helpful. So the next book I'm gonna recommend is much older. It is called the PGM, or the Greek Magical Papyri. The Greek Magical Papyri is the only ceremonial magic text we have from ancient Greece. It actually sort of dispels this myth that pagans don't do ceremonial magic, because it's a very ceremonial book. There's a certain ritual within it called the Headless Rite that you see in Thelema under the name the Bornless Ritual. And people use this ritual, which is an exorcism in the PGM, in rituals like Goetia to help connect to their holy guardian angels. So even if you're a Western modern practitioner, the PGM is super helpful. As well, for any pagans or polytheist watching, this is like the source from your time period. You can find incenses to specific deities. You can find invocations. Personally, there's an invocation to Hecate that like makes my heart like explode of joy. It's a beautiful text, and it's one of the few pieces we have from that period. So I think it should be a staple in any polytheist sort of collection of books, and it should be in every ceremonial magician's, because it has so many ceremonial ideas. And as well, you see some really interesting cultural exchange with Kabbalistic practices. So you can see that the Abrahamic pagan divide in ceremonial magic was always a lot more syncretized than we sometimes think it is. Sometimes we think that things like Thelema brought paganism and ceremonial magic together, and then you read the PGM and you're like, wow, that's not true at all. The next text I'm gonna recommend is one that doesn't get talked about as much, but is super influential, and that is the Artabelle. The Artabelle is a grimoire from 1575 that includes things like the Olympian spirits, which are not really discussed anywhere else. It's a very influential Christian text. And if you're looking into Theosophy, which I've not made a video on Theosophy, I could if you guys want. This really influenced Theosophy in particular. It's a really interesting grimoire. It has certain things like the Tetragrammaton in it in an interesting way. And it's a really great way to explore the grimoire tradition. It's a classic for a reason, and it's pretty good. So if you're interested in grim trad, Artabelle is one to have on your list, even if it is sometimes not talked about. Next one on my list is the Keys of Solomon. So the Keys of Solomon is not like one book. There's the Lesser Key and the Greater Key, and within those keys, there are a bunch of sub-books. But basically, the Lesser and Greater Key of Solomon are probably the most influential ceremonial magic books of all time. If you looked into ceremonial magic, one of the first traditions you're gonna hear about is Goetia, or working with goetic demons, where you use the power of God to bind demons. This is from that text. This text is iconic for a reason. It's influenced horror films like Hereditary. It's iconic. Aleister Crowley worked with it. People like Samuel McGregor Mathers have discussed it. E.A. Waite did. Like, it's been discussed by everyone. Even in the left-hand path and satanic and demonolatry traditions, the Keys of Solomon are heavily used to form those practices. So to say this book has been influential is an understatement. It's actually not that long either. A good version of it, this is maybe a hot take, I actually really like Waite's Book of Black Magic, which is like his translation version of it. There's also been Crowley's Illustrated Goetia. There's a lot of sort of reworks of these and like people who have made them into like a published version. There are a bunch of them. It's also out of copyright, so you can read it royalty-free legally, which is really nice. A lot of these texts are older, so they're actually out of copyright, which means places like Hermetic Library and Sacred Texts, which are legal free ways to read, will have them. But this is like the key. If you're only gonna read one ceremonial magic book, this will be the one. And we all love binding demons. There's something kind of exciting about it, and I think it's a classic practice and so iconically associated with ceremonial magic for a reason. My next recommendation is gonna be The Pick of Tricks. The Pick of Tricks is an Arabic grimoire that is the basis of a lot of traditional astrological practices and is the key book for planetary magic. When we talk about modern planetary magic, a lot of people get really into this book called Seven Spheres, but planetary magic is an ancient practice. It's one that goes way back, and this text is one of the things that's commonly referenced. We get a lot of our understanding of like types of rituals, types of preparations to make on specific transits and days off of this book. As well, this gives some really interesting ideas that have influenced me. I really like how it discusses that the energies you work with and the planets you work with can influence you, and the idea that you want to balance the planetary energies within you, so you work with planets that are like opposite to your nature. I think that's a really unique idea. You see it sort of brought into Crowley's writing when Crowley talks about how people should work with both masculine and feminine energies. But in this book, you see this idea that you're supposed to balance out the planetary energies in a way similar to humoric medicine. That's really interesting. Though I will give a caveat about The Pick of Tricks. Some of the like recipes in it are like mildly toxic by modern standards. So be a little careful if you're like making ritual, like preparations and incenses off of this book. Some of that stuff's not really up to date, but it's a classic planetary magic text. If you want to get into planetary magic, this is the one. Comment below if I should make a planetary magic video. I think that could be really interesting. Next book I'm going to recommend, and this is going to be the most basic recommendation on this list. If you've ever been on a cult Discord, you're probably going to have someone at some point tell you to read Agrippa. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna tell you to read Agrippa. So Agrippa is boring. Agrippa is long. I think Agrippa is basically the lawnmower manual of occultism, right? It's dry, but it's where so many of our theories are from. And it's one of those books that explain why magic works, why do we do the things we do, why do we do all these ritual practices, what's the point? This book actually explains that. It's long, it's painful to read, but it has information you need to read. I think everyone should read it before they die. I will go against the online occult consensus that you should read this when you're new. I think a new practitioner is gonna read 5 pages of this and give up and say, no occultism for me. No, I think you should read this once you have some experience, but it's a great book. A lot of our ideas come from it. There is also this thing called Agrippa's fourth book. That's not by real Agrippa. So a thing you're gonna see with a lot of these older ceremonial magic texts is these authors will be credited for a ton of things. That author didn't write all of that. They just like attributed random shit to people. King Solomon gets the same thing. They'll just like attribute stuff to him. Same with like Hermes Trismegistrius. Like they'll just start like saying books are by this person when they're just from the time and similar. History kind of does that. Maybe one day there'll be some books attributed to me. YouTube viewers in 3000, please attribute books to me. I would appreciate it. Thank you. But yeah, like that's a thing that happens. So the fourth book is interesting. I read the fourth book, pretty cool, but it's not the same as the main three and it's not part of the main three. So just be aware. Next, I'm gonna recommend John Dee's 5 Books of Mystery. So John Dee created Enochian. If you're familiar with Thelema or Golden Dawn, you're gonna be familiar with Enochian magic. There's this thing that we do called Neo-Enochiana, which is basically the Enochian system that came out of the Golden Dawn based on John Dee's books and writings. They didn't have all the translations and like information that we have now. So they were actually working off of stuff that we didn't have, meaning that their system is at times kind of incomplete, missing some things, like some of the tables are really different. But John Dee is the one who came up with it. So reading John Dee's work directly will give you what they call Dee Purist, which is kind of a more cool, hip way to do Enochian now, because now we have the information that the Golden Dawn and Crowley didn't have. So by reading Dee directly, you can learn how Dee worked with Enochian. For those who aren't familiar, Enochian is a specific system of magic where you work with angels that John Dee and his assistant scryer, Edward Kelly, created. I think it's an interesting system. I will say, please don't do a Enochian as a beginner. I find out of any ceremonial practice, Enochian tends to be the most risky. I don't precisely know why, and I don't really know how to articulate why, but just based on my own experience and UPG, I find that Enochian is a practice that can really mess with people and kind of push people beyond their limits in ways that can be a little risky. So if you're gonna do anything John Dee or Enochian related, please ground yourself. There's a reason why the Golden Dawn didn't teach people Enochian until they were in the really high degrees. It's just kind of a risky practice. So just be aware if you're gonna look into John Dee's work that this stuff can be a little risky. So just keep that in mind. And the final thing I'm gonna recommend is a thing that I've done a video on as a Thelemite. Of course, I care a lot about this one. And that is the Sacred Magic of Abraham Melin the Mage. So Abraham of Worms, this German dude in the 1300s, 1400s. We don't have the exact dates because, you know, record keeping. But basically this guy met a bunch of mystics. He traveled all around and he did this huge ritual called the Abraham Melin ritual, where he retreated from society and did a ton of stuff and then connected to what is essentially his holy guardian angel. This text has been hugely influential and popularized by the Golden Dawn and Aleister Crowley. It kind of went under the radar for a couple centuries. And then with the Golden Dawn and Crowley, it became, you know, really popular again. It had a resurgence and that influence came back. As a Thelemite, I think your Holy Guardian Angel is a really important thing to tap into. For those who don't know, the Holy Guardian Angel is essentially a guiding, watching spirit that sort of guides you and helps you follow along your natural path towards divinity. And this is the most classic way to do it. I do find that the Abraham Melin ritual is very hard to pull off in 2021. It's kind of difficult to do. There's a lot of restrictions on your life you have to take. But this is an influential text. There's also magic squares in it that you can use outside of the Abraham Melin ritual. So it's worth reading, even if you're not gonna like take all the months of your life and do the Abraham Melin ritual proper. There's still a lot of influence from it. As well, there was recently a better translation made. I've only read the one that Samuel McGregor Mathers of the Golden Dawn did, but they recently released like a new translation that apparently has like a whole extra book in it, because there's three sub books within this. A lot of these texts, you'll see sub books within the book. But yeah, like apparently there's a new one that's better. I haven't read it, but it does seem to be more complete. And I've personally been wanting to get my hands on it. So maybe that'll be my next book purchase. But basically, these are sort of the 10 books that I think every ceremonial magician should read. Make sure you're applying things from this. You don't want to go full armchair magician. So make sure you read this stuff and then actually use it. If you want to support me, I'm Georgina Rose or Dot Darling, D-A-A-T. You can subscribe to my Patreon for extra videos. I do an extra video every month. I do ritual guides and you can bug me with questions on Patreon and I will respond to them. As well, if you pay into the higher tiers, I do things like mentoring and stuff. So if you want to talk to me one-on-one, join the Patreon. If you want to support me but you don't want to join the Patreon, donate to my Ko-Fi. It's direct donations, so you can just donate once. As well, I'm on Instagram. I post every day. I'm on TikTok. I post twice a day. I'm on Twitch. I stream Mondays and Tuesday nights with my co-host Warrior Witch Nike. We host a podcast together called Magnolias and Magic. It's on all major podcasting platforms, and is that also as a Patreon where you can get extended shows and extra shows every Neo-Pagan Sabbat. I'm on every major social media platform excluding Facebook. So find me places. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and ring the bell, and subscribe for 93 days and you'll meet your holy guardian angel. And then you don't have to read any of these books. Fuck reading. You can just like be Gnosis. All right, have a good day.